I've already shuffled and will be taking a look at the recent past energy between you and your person. We'll find out what's coming up for you and your person. We'll take a look and see what the challenge is going to be, and then we'll find out what the outcome is. So, Cancer, the recent past energy between you and your person, Wheel of Fortune, and the Death card. Now, the Wheel of Fortune, it's a card that reminds us that this too shall pass. Whether it's good times or bad times, it passes. If suddenly you find yourself sitting on top of the world, keep your perspective, as that too, like everything else, changes. Live in the now, count your blessings, and just realize that much of life is really outside of our control, but that's even okay. Roll with the changes and think positive. Well, Fortune is with the Death card, which is a card that does not necessarily or even usually indicate physical death. In fact, it is considered irresponsible for readers to predict physical death, because we're all creatures with free will and such things. They're simply not written in stone. The Death card, it does indicate transformation. It indicates change. This is a time of deep transformation. It could be both internally and externally in your life. Maybe some situations, things, and people that you have counted on or have gotten used to may no longer be available to you in quite the same way as they once were. As they once were. Keep in mind, though, this transition, it can be very difficult for some people, even though the change is nearly always needed. So the recent past energy between you and your person, Wheel of Fortune, clarified by the Death card. So what I am getting here, I'm picking up that you could have been seeing someone for a while, or maybe it was someone that you just met, and you felt really lucky to have this person come into your life. A lot of you Aries felt very fortunate. You felt like luck was on your side for once to have met someone like this. But because the Death card is here, it felt like this person, it felt like they lost interest. Yeah, things might have been going good for a while, or like I said, maybe you just met this person and you probably felt like this was the one. This person made you feel like you've come into good fortune. It felt like a turning point for you in your life. And this person might have ghosted you. And you felt like they lost interest. Maybe they came to some type of conclusion. Yeah, because a Death card can be about that. Yes, it can. So, yeah, a lot of you got ghosted by your person that you thought was the one. And you just felt like they lost interest. That's what I'm getting for the majority. Not all of you Cancers, but that's just the energy that I'm feeling. You felt like you got ghosted, and the person just, they probably didn't even say much. She just kind of disappeared. Anyway, let's get off of that. Let's move on over. Let's take a look and see. Let's see what's coming up for the two of you. You have the Knight of Cups. And it's with the Emperor. Now, the Knight of Cups, like most of the cups in the tarot, it's optimistic. It's a good card to see in the reading. This one comes with messages. Usually, they're the kind of good news that we all want to receive. The Knight of Cups, it tells you that things are going to be going well. You're likely to be feeling charged up, ready for action. The Knight of Cups is about good news, especially when it comes to matters of the heart. Yeah. Somebody's rushing in. Somebody's headed your way soon with the Knight of Cups. Now, it's with the Emperor. The Emperor shows that domination over the mind, over the heart, is sometimes necessary, even though it's not wanted. In fact, it should be welcomed, and that's what you must think about when you get the Emperor in a reading. And I say this because when hard choices have to be made, it is important to maintain your concentration and focus. Well, the Emperor actually signals this, but he also signals that now is a time you find it easier to make hard choices. And I say this because the Emperor is the type that they only use their head. Only their head and not their heart. So enjoy the assertiveness, enjoy the confidence, and the self-control and focus that this brings. Do what you know is best, because if you can master yourself, then you'll have very little problems mastering most of the other obstacles that life can throw at you. So, Cancer coming up, Knight of Cups clarified by the Emperor. So, yeah, well, what do you know? What do you know? Here comes this person that walked away. Made you feel like they abandoned you. Here they come rushing in. If you're wondering, will you ever hear from this person again? Yes. They're coming in. They're rushing in. That's them up there. The Knight of Cups, the card above the word present. The Knight of Cups coming in to be romantic and sensitive. The person has something to say. They're charged up and ready for action. But that's you down there, the Emperor. Stone cold. The Emperor, like I said, is the type that only uses his head, not his heart. As you can tell by the look on his face, if you put your screen on, if you blow it up, you can see how cold this Emperor looks. Yeah, the Emperor is the type that does not want to come across as being vulnerable. This person could be a leader, a boss, really arrogant. They don't really open their hearts, and that's how you feel. You're not opening up your heart to this person. Yeah. But here they come. What do you know? Yeah, whenever I see the Emperor, I get chills. The Emperor is so cold. Makes you feel like you're outside in the middle of a winter blizzard, freezing below zero winter blizzard with no clothes on, outside, just freezing to death. That's a chilling feel and thought when I see the Emperor. Yeah, the Emperor is the type that rather have you die wanting to know what's inside their heart. So, that's you. You're going cold on this person. Rightfully so. They just ghosted you. Made you feel rejected. Abandoned. And you thought this person was the one. So, let's move on over. Let's take a look and see. Let's see what's the challenges. We got the Strength card. and it's with the Two of Wands. Now, the Strength card, with this one, it's important for you to make time to meditate, contemplate, spend some time alone, even if you're in a committed relationship and you have 19 kids. So don't allow yourself to spend time in preoccupation and fear, because the things around you, the outward things, they'll be going all right, but what's most important is keeping your head on straight. At this time, not only do you have the ability, but you have the responsibility. So conquer your fears, control your impulses, and never lose patience with yourself for what you're trying to do. Strength card is with the Two of Wands. With the Two of Wands, it's important for you to keep your balance in every way that you can, even to the mundane, boring things like eating right, getting enough rest. The Two of Wands also often indicates a partnership with another person. This could be business or personal or both. It reminds us to stay mindful to the give and take that's required for successful relationships. And if things are feeling out of balance for you now, just know that they're about to get substantially better. Keep your eyes on the prize. So basically, the challenge for you, Cancer, Strength card, clarified by the Two of Wands. So it looks like, your priority is you. Because the Strength card can be about self-love, unconditional love, self-respect. That's what it can be about. It's about being your best you. I'm getting a lot of you are working on yourself so that you can have a stronger mind, body, and soul. Yeah, because maybe this person, they might have shook your confidence when they just walked away like that. So you might be trying to build yourself back up. Even though they come rushing in, you've gone cold on them. And I'm getting that you had been working on yourself for a while, or at least since they walked away, trying to build your self-confidence back up. Self-love, self-respect. Yeah. So, it's with this Two of Wands, though, so I'm getting that you could have two paths towards a future. Yeah, I don't think you're going to jump back towards this person. You've got options, Cancer. You've got options here, because if you take a look at the Two of Wands, it's the card that's below the word challenge. You see this man, he's sitting down. He's got his hand tied to one wand. His back is to it, though. So you might be a little interested in this emperor. Maybe you kind of have a little interest, not the emperor, but the Knight of Cups, this person that comes rushing back. Or maybe this is someone else. You've got options here. If you don't feel like it now, you will soon. Yeah, because your light is about to shine. When you work on yourself and you build yourself up, your confidence, it beams. So, saying that, you're going to have options here. Your hand is going to be tied to someone or something, but your back is to them, and you're focused on the other one. Your ankle is tied to it. Your body language is to it. And you're looking directly into the eyes of the other one, and you're smiling. So there's someone that's coming up that's really getting you excited. And then the other person or situation, you're interested, but you got your back to it. The other really, really sparks your interest. So yeah, that can happen when you work on yourself. You get all these options coming your way. Yeah, confidence, self-love, self-respect. It's a powerful, potent thing. People can be drawn to that. So, let's see what the outcome is. We got this Ten of Wands and Three of Wands. On the Ten of Wands, you could feel as though you're carrying a heavy burden. You may want to look hard at this to see if there are any ways that you could lighten your load, either literally or figuratively. Because if you look carefully, you could find that part of the burden you're carrying emotionally, it actually belongs to someone else. So it's important for you to pace yourself. Try not to take on too much. Now, so the Three of Wands. Three of Wands, you could find your finances, they're going much better. In fact, it could feel like it's a time where your ship has finally arrived. So you're likely to be feeling really strong with a good reason. You could start to finally experience some important success after you've been through some difficulty. The Three of Wands, it can refer to work in a very positive way. Even if you don't work outside the home, it means that your efforts, they're seen, they're appreciated, they're well respected. So give yourself some credit. So your outcome, Cancer. Ten of Wands, clarified by the Three of Wands. So yeah, like I said, your person, they want back in. I don't know why they just walked away before. I don't know why they did that. They want back in. But you're being really ice cold towards them. You're very cold. You're not opening up your heart. You're working on yourself. You're trying to be the best you. You can be. And then you got these options here. Someone, two people you're interested in, or maybe you got two paths towards the future. And you're just trying to make a decision when you get the Two of Wands. Yeah, you're not sure which path to take, but you got options. So like I said, your person, they want to come back being romantic and sensitive. They see that you're looking in another direction. You're not facing them. They see it, they feel it. They see that you have a new strength about yourself. You have a new light that's shining on you. They see something is different. In a good way. They feel like it could be too difficult to try to get back into your good graces. Yeah, because if you look at the Ten of Wands, it's the card above the word outcome. This man, he's actually walking forward with these wands in his hand, but he's about to fall backwards. So that's, if your person feels like it's going to be like an uphill battle, trying to get back in your good graces, but they want back in. That's them, the Knight of Cups. But like I said, you're going towards something else, because I'm just looking at the way you're smiling at this other one, and your ankle is tied to it. Your body language is saying yes. So, yeah, I think a lot of you are preparing for 2021, because that's right around the corner. A lot of you have a lot of plans for yourself, for the future, a lot of new beginnings that you're working towards. And with this Three of Wands here, it looks like for the outcome, you're no longer trying to make a decision. Because the Two of Wands is about trying to make a decision. But when you get the Three of Wands, you've made a decision. You feel like your ship is here. You're going, you're getting on board. You've made a decision and you're going forward. You're looking ahead and you're expanding and there's growth. So this is, the outcome is actually really good for you. Yeah, you're no longer trying to figure out which path to take. Yeah, you've made it. You've made a decision. Your ship has arrived. You're getting on board. So this is really, really positive. I don't know what are your plans, but I'm getting, like I said, for a lot of you, it's something really positive that you're working on. So maybe it's just a, maybe it's a new beginning for the new year. Could be with a person that you're going forward with, or it could be just a new beginning. Maybe just overall in life, or with life, or with something, some type of plan or goal that you have in mind. So good for you, Cancer. Yeah. So that is your reading. I hope you enjoy the reading. I hope it resonates. As you know, general readings, they do not always resonate with everyone. Then again, if you like the reading, please comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell. That way you'll be notified when I post my next reading. I'll also put a link below of the extended of this reading where I'll go over how you both feel about the situation. What's in the near future for the two of you? How do you see yourself? Best case scenario, and what will happen between the two of you in the next few weeks? There's also a link below for personal readings if you'd like to try one of those. So Cancer, I thank you so very much for watching. I hope all of you are doing well and staying safe during this crazy virus season. Can you believe that the numbers picked back up for this virus? The numbers are back up. So hang in there. We'll all get through this. Stay strong. Take good care of yourself. Come back and join me for the next Cancer reading. Just in case this did not resonate, maybe the next reading will. Also, keep in mind when you get the readings, if you're not dealing with anyone romantically, the other person could be a situation. It could be a friend or a family member or a coworker. And yes, the roles, they can be switched. You could be your person or your person could be you. So take the reading for however it resonates, because these are general readings. They're not personal readings. So Cancer, I can never say it enough. Thank you so very much for watching. I'm wishing you all happy holidays. I hope to see you at the next reading. Have a great day and take care.